What is up, my fellow wizards, and welcome to the third episode of Playing EDH. Today, we're going to be playing Arch Enemy. I'm going to start off by playing Sidisi. So Sidisi wants to mill me slowly and mill my opponents incrementally. It wants to get creatures in the graveyard, bring them into play, and hit you all with them.
Hi, Mom. It's me, Jose. I'm back again playing Cathrall. So I want to get a bunch of creatures in my graveyard, put some keywords on Cathrall, and swing. And that's it.
What's up, Michael? Playing Gabe. It's basically getting a bunch of sapperlings on the field, trying to infinite mana and infinite counters, and see how it goes.
And I'm Alonzo, I'm back again, because y'all were so salty from the last game that I had to come back and get a 3v1 in. Alright, so playing Arch Enemy, so I'm keep it flavorful. I got Nicol Bolas, the Ravager. We did a deck tech on this recently. So, long story short, it has flying. I'm going to enter the battlefield. Each opponent discards a card. And then for 4, blue, black, and red, I can transform it into a planeswalker, and it does more fun stuff.
So, if you guys don't know how to play Arch Enemy, I will have a quick description on how to play down below. Check it out. In the meantime, we'll say Alonzo goes first as the Arch Enemy.
And as Arch Enemy, the first action in any Arch Enemy game is to flip these cards, Arch Enemy cards, and it says, your fate is thrice sealed. Fun. When you set this scheme in motion, reveal the top 3 cards of your library. Put all land cards revealed this way onto the battlefield and the rest into your hand. So, at the beginning of the game, I mulliganed down to 5. And the way that I mulliganed down was just drawing 5 and scrying 2, so...
Oh.
Wow! All 3 colors already on the battlefield. This is going to be great. So I'm going to put this right here on top. Now, that being said, I haven't drawn for turn yet, but Halimar Depth says, when it enters the battlefield, look at the top 3 cards in my library and put them back in any order. Oh, 1, 2, 3. Oh my lord. So I'm going to do it like that. And then I'm going to start my turn. Hey, that's pretty neat. I'm going to look at target player's hand and then draw a card. I want to look at your hand, Nick. Let me see. Goody, goody. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, ooh. Ew. Ew. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. You take that back. I paid 2 life for that, by the way. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna draw a card. Oh, look, I didn't expect that to be a fucking card. So, I'm gonna start by playing a command tower. Add 1 mana of any color to my mana pool. Mm-hmm. And with that, exhaustingly great turn, I'm gonna pass to you 3.
All right, so we will each take our turn at the same time.
Great. Isn't it? That's great. See, that one's just luck. Just pure luck.
I'm gonna lay down a Rejuvenating Springs. It enters the battlefield tapped on the side of 2 or more opponents. I only have 1 in this game.
Swamp, Torch of Existence. I can pay a black, choose and discard a creature card, return target creature card from your graveyard to your hand.
Oh, it's an enchantment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Got it. So yeah, you can discard the same card and then return it to your hand, even though, like, if you have some kind of synergies with that, that'd be, great.
And then I'll pass. Are you going to do yours, though?
Yeah, Soul Ring? Pretty neat. It'd be a shame if I didn't do anything about it.
Yeah, Mr. 4 lands over there. That's cool.
Yeah, blame the luck of the draw here. Yeah. You guys ready for this?
So is the first 3. That's the fun part.
My wish is your command. When you set this scheme in motion, each opponent reveals his or her hand. I can choose a non-creature, non-land card revealed this way and cast it without paying its mana cost. That's nice.
Alright,
I'll start with you. Non-creature, non-land, right?
Casting Ashiok.
No, I'm just holding it for now.
You only pick 1 out of
the only one is gas.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
I can't pick you in for that.
Oh, okay then, yes.
You can have that back.
There's no mana cost.
But yeah. Nope. All right, Ashiok it is.
What is Ashiok?
Ashiok's a planeswalker. I'm going to keep you over here because you're...
Oh, that fucking dude.
Yeah, that lady. The dude.
Fucking...
It's the first non-binary Marvel. Magic character. That's the real first non-binary one. We don't know if it's a he or she. Now, that being said, I draw for turn. I will play yet another blue for turn. I'm going to move this over here to the black side. So spells and abilities your opponents control can't cause your controller to search their library. So no fetch lands, no searching for anything at all. Screw you.
All day.
And I'm also going to subtract this by 4.
You're fucking kidding me.
I'm going to mill you for 4, and everybody, all my opponents, exile their graveyard.
Done.
Exile. Thank you, sir. Oh, I should have done that second. But I'll do this like this. Nicol Bolas the Ravager. When it enters the battlefield, each of you discards a card. I did a little backwards, but gave you a little time to get your stuff back.
Discarded Null Mage Shepherd.
I'll do Rose. I'll do Atreos.
I am very happy with this result. I shall pass.
No shit. You've got the first, one of the two best cards to play.
Yeah, I know, right?
Muck Water Pathway. Tap two. Cast Skull Prophet.
Cool.
Command Tower.
Like a Command Tower.
In the pathway. Thank you for surviving on the stand. Pay green. Choose a discarded creature card. Search your library for creature card. Reveal it.
You can't.
Yeah, I'm not right now. Yeah.
Just on with it. Fucking exciting.
Yeah, it's a good card. Cool.
Exciting.
Hey, guess what you can't do?
Anything.
Search.
I know.
That's smart, Talbot.
What does that do?
It's just an upkeep, and when I do three, I can make a sapling.
And then you can sacrifice a sapling to get it. Minus one on the creature. Okay, that's pretty neat. Alright.
Go ahead.
I'll let all that live for now. Skip that one again. The Fate of the Flammable. Oh, that sounds fun. When you set the scheme in motion, target opponent chooses self or others. If that player chooses self, the scheme deals 6 damage to him or her. If the player chooses others, the scheme does 3 damage to each of your other opponents. Jose, yourself or others?
So others would be the best move, right, for everyone? I'll take 3.
No,
just those two.
You don't take anything. You take three.
It's
or
a little
you
selfish.
Take 6.
Just a little selfish.
We'll do that one. Because that'll be down at 14?
Yeah.
You'd be down at 14
yeah.
if that happened.
Go ahead and
I'm personally
three.
Fine with either decision.
Yeah, we'll do the other one then. You two take 3.
Hey. That's what
we
I like to see.
Survive.
Everybody squirming a little bit.
Yeah. You had 4 land turn 1.
Love it. Yeah, right? I mean, that's just
you literally got the
luck.
Best the best starting
dumbest
end.
Of luck.
Yeah.
I'm not even salty.
That's just, we gotta beat him, man. We
gotta Jose,
the
4 in the air.
I'll take it.
And commander
and he
damage
stopped us from
count.
Searching for more land and shit.
Right. We're not gonna count commander damage in this arch enemy game.
No, we're not. 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 6 mana. I'm going to tap 4 to cast Drawn from Dreams. I get to look at the top 7 cards in my library and put 2 of them in my hand, the rest of them in the bottom of my library in any order.
I don't like it.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's a lot of cards to go through, right? Mm-hmm. I like it. Oof. Don't have to reveal them, thankfully. And then I will take this down to 3. And I will mill Nick for 4, and all you guys exile your graveyards.
No.
Oof. Okay.
Exile your graveyard.
Oh, and away it goes.
And then I shall pass my turn to you 3.
Please be something I can use.
For a Dryad Sophisticated. Non-basic land walk, 2/1.
Non-basic land walk, pretty neat.
For Zhang Yanggu, Wildcrafter, each creature you control with a 1/1 counter on it has had that many. I also need to.
Josh Kim.
Upkeep. Counter. Going to minus him. 2. Add counter on him.
Pay 2 black and cast Stompy Voidwalker.
Let me see it.
Sure.
What does it do?
If a card would be put into an opponent's graveyard from anywhere, exile it into the void counter. Oh. Neat.
And for once, I'm not scared of that.
Right?
2 teammates.
That's all I got. Can anybody get me a mana somewhere? I could really use one.
I can't search for anything.
That's true.
I can't. He literally fucked us in 2 turns.
he stopped the Vanna Ramp, and he's getting to himself.
Well, now we have more creatures than he has creatures, so we'll get rid of the Planeswalker.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Can we block for each other? We cannot.
No, we can't block for each other. But we can individually swing.
Yeah, so next turn, that's what I'm saying. Next turn I can do two to it. But I mean, I'm sure it's going to be dead next turn.
I got nothing else if you guys are good.
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
You know what? I do. I have one more spell.
Or I can do this, just not going to sell out.
World Razor with Reach. Yep.
Nice.
And I have no land to put onto the battlefield for my hand, so I'm going to ignore its ETB. And that's all I got.
You could swing at it right now, didn't you?
Yeah, but if
it wouldn't kill it.
Okay.
But it would take it down, so it couldn't do much with it.
So he could still fuck whatever I'm going to do. Nice. So instead of that Fecundity, whenever a creature dies, that creature's controller may draw a card.
Okay.
Cool.
That's nice.
And pass.
On your end step. On y'all's end step. I'm going to tap two. One in the blue. To flash in Omen to see. It's an enchantment with flash, and it says, when it enters the battlefield, scry two and then draw a card.
You draw the first card that's done, right?
Scry two, draw a card. That's how I'm going to do it. It says from anywhere or from the library.
Yeah.
What does that do?
He's talking about Dothi, so if shit hits his graveyard, it gets exiled with a void counter on it, and I can cast that for free.
All right.
By casting, sacking Dothi.
New scheme. When I set this scheme into motion, it's called Which of You Burns Brightest? When you set the scheme in motion, you may pay X. If I do, this scheme deals X damage to target opponent, each creature he or she controls.
Took two turns, bro. Took two turns.
I'm gonna tap one swamp to do one damage to you and one damage to each creature you control.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Of course me. So what, two I assume? Or three?
Just one.
Just one?
Just one damage.
It's gonna kill my skull.
Alright. And then I draw. Final of five, man, that sucks.
Good for you.
Nick, I'm swinging at you for four in the air.
Yes, you are.
I literally can't search for things. That's the only thing that's doing it.
And that's what the exiling on did right there. Not too good.
I doubt
the that's the thing that makes it to where we can't search? Is your void?
Is your Ashiok.
This plane's water, yeah.
Gotcha.
Tap four. Ley Line Anticipation.
You can play things at flash speed.
I can.
Cool.
And you've got one mana open. You've
got one mana of any color available. You guys got powers over here. So I'm going to go down to two, and I haven't hit you yet. So Jose, mill four, and all y'all exile your graveyards.
Underground Stadium. Concentrate effort. No. First in arena. And a nesting ground.
All that gets exiled, sir. And then you guys are up.
You're done?
How much did I take?
None.
Oh, okay. I took damage.
Awesome. 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 So awesome.
Okay.
Gabe's coming up.
I'm going to do planes and a pathway for Rogue Mach Swiftwing.
I will take care of the planeswalker. Do you want to go to combat first if you can still search?
Right now.
If we go to combat.
Okay, cool. Go to combat.
So we're going to go to combat, and I'm going to swing Dothi at the planeswalker.
Should we swing something else?
You should, whatever he's going to do.
He only has one thing.
I would swing back.
I can swing both. So I can just swing this at the planeswalker with just in case, or this one, because this is unblockable, non-basic lands. And this one can just go at his face.
Just swing the unblockable.
That's what I was saying.
Don't even fucking hit yours. Or just swing it. One of you swing at him. Just take the two. But
He has one mana open. We don't know if he has removal, so I'm saying we should at least send two at his planeswalker.
Yeah,
okay. Fair.
And then I'll just do one at his face.
Cool. So that's combat. Response. Blocker. No blockers. Response.
It does.
Okay.
See?
Cool.
That's one to do evil hard.
That. Yeah, you definitely. One, two, three, four.
37.
Playing Sky Shroud Claim. Up to two basic forest cards. Up to two forest cards. Excuse me.
Battlefield untapped, right?
Battlefield untapped.
I'm going to tap one green to activate Survival of the Fittest, and I'm going to be pitching a Hornet Queen to the graveyard. And I'll go search for a creature.
Nice.
You have to reveal it?
Yeah. I'm gonna bring
a... So
yeah! Nice. Let's go!
What does it do?
Zatalpa just has flying, double strike, vigilance, trample, and indestructible. So my commander, if I get that in the graveyard, would have all that and death touch, as the graveyards are.
And with that, I'm going to tap five him to bring out Gave. So I have two mana next turn more, and I have Gave now. Okay. Play my man for turn and be done.
What you got, Alonzo?
I'm going to pay a blue to Pongify your Galthi Voidwalker. So you get to draw a card anyway, but you also get a 3-3 monkey.
Wow.
That's it, you guys?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
All right, just making sure. All right, new scheme. Let's see what happens. Shake them up. All shall smolder in my wake. When I set the scheme in motion, destroy up to one target artifact, one target enchantment, and one target non-basic land.
Wow.
Stinky.
You got artifacts over there?
I do not.
No soul ring or anything?
Has. Oh, I have soul ring.
Yeah, get rid of that.
I mean, these enchantments are fine to destroy.
Great job. And then, yeah, survival of the fittest, get rid of it.
All right.
And then non-basic land.
All three of them?
No, he has
two. No, I mean, you destroy you one of each, right? No, I have
this
one.
This is all my lands.
How many lands you have?
Be merciful. Five,
six.
You only have two?
Yeah.
I have non-basics.
Yeah, two of every color, just about, except for black. Get rid of your black.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I thought they were sovereign. We might have something. Or man.
Well, you can give me one moment. I got to urinate. Forgive me, Nick.
But I pass.
Everybody knows. True actors go in their pants. Never break character.
Okay.
They land for turn.
Burden Catacombs is my land for turn. I'll pay one life. And I will go searching for a swamp or a forest.
So what I'm gonna do is tap the command tower for black, and then I'm gonna discard Zatalpa, and I'll return the Hornet Queen back to my hand.
Dude, this is breaking my heart.
Yeah. We can do this.
I needed that survival of the fittest, for sure.
And I needed Sol Ring. Well, I didn't need Sol Ring, I needed not top deck, because I have two options right now.
I also drew a land.
I searched a Bayou, by the way.
We can't attack him either.
Two.
I mean, we all can. Well, someone will for sure.
Corpse Knight.
I want both of these in the graveyard anyway, so I'll swing both.
There you go.
Yeah.
Good.
And he can't block this anyway, so it's gonna get through for two every time. And he'll just kill this, and I'll have first strike in the graveyard, one more keyboard.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna drop him down to one and summon a sapling. And that's gonna make him lose one turn.
Well.
Alright.
Combat?
Yeah, going to combat.
Alright, so I'm gonna swing both at you. The Dryad Sophisticate, non basic land walk so you can't block, and then the Swift Wing, 2-1.
I'm swinging.
Or 1-2.
I'm gonna swing at five. And I'll lower Josh King to 1. To put a counter on this team. Okay, yep, that's what I'm gonna go. Go nuts.
So we got a 5-5, a 1-2, a 2-1?
Two, two.
Yeah, 2-2.
Yeah,
2-2. Yeah, 3-3.
This is
unblockable
anyway. So
yeah, I can't block that one. 1-2. Yeah, at least 2. And then take another one from the 1. And I guess I'm taking 5. And killing a 3-3.
Yeah, sure. It'll be okay.
No, I'm just like, I need a card. So you died. Something of yours died, right?
Yes.
Draw a card.
I can still draw. It's great. I thought he got rid of that with the last spell. Cool.
You know what? I'm literally just going to tap one and sack this to put a point on Gave and draw a card because I need to.
Answers?
Answers?
Oh my god, how much mana do you have? You have everything! He has everything!
He's not even phased by
He's not! It's not! Because he's gonna fuck it up! I can't do anything with it! I hate it. I can't do anything with it. He's just gonna counter.
Well, I mean, then we got the counter out of his hands.
Yeah, that's true.
So we might as well make him play.
No!
What are you gonna do?
No.
Go ahead.
This is not the thing to get countered.
Okay. Shot.
Oh yeah, you guys can see what I got. I just realized that.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, do you see my problem?
So then just wait.
Yeah.
He's gotta play his mana at some point.
Alright, well then, in response to that, I'm gonna tap two more, because I can't do anything, and I'm gonna make him go down one, up one, and create another sapling, kill it, and draw a card.
Cool.
This enters the battlefield tapped.
What is it?
My land.
It's a land. Not in Doth, like the...
Yeah, Dotha,
right?
Yes. And because I have nothing else I can fucking do, I'm gonna do it again. Cool, and pass my turn.
Alright,
yeah, I'm good. I'm gonna tap one of the blue for Latinum Legacy. Love this card. You might have never heard of it. I get to choose a card from my hand and shuffle that card into my library, then I get to draw two cards at the beginning of the next turn's upkeep.
Ooh, what are you gonna do?
Nice. Take Magical Worm out of my hand, shuffle it into my library. Does anybody want to cut my deck? Anybody?
Okay.
Offer? There you go. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
And then I'm going to tap Grixis for Croesus' Charm. I'm going to return Gabe to your hand.
Boop.
In response to that, since I can't block any of your things anyways, I'm going to tap two. I'm going to go him down to four, and then I'm going to create two saplings, yes, before he goes back to my hand. I wish saplings had flying. Oh, I'd like to do it three times since I had another mana, and I'm not going to be able to do it anything else with that mana.
Okay.
Cool.
That's it.
All on that.
Are we ready for more pain?
Oh, my pain. What's this one?
Let's find out. Make yourself useful. When you set this game in motion, destroy a target creature and opponent controls. If a creature is destroyed this way, you gain life equal to its toughness.
I got a 0-3.
I just got some weak 1-2s. Don't even look over here.
Corpse Knight.
Corpse Knight?
Corpse Knight. I'll gain 3 life.
You draw a card?
Yes, you do. And then I get to draw 2 cards on my upkeep and 1 card per turn. Thanks a lot, Nom's Legacy. And then I'm just gonna play the Joker Bog tapped and exile your graveyard.
No.
Oh.
Goodbye.
Does it talk
Wait, so in response, could I tap this and switch this card out real quick?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna do that. Yeah. So in response, I'll pay one.
You gotta discard a creature card, right?
Yeah, so I'm gonna discard Hornet Queen and then bring this back to my hand. And then that'll get exiled.
Dope.
Neat.
Power place.
That is how that works.
Yeah, let's do it.
Mike, hit him for 4. In the R.
Okay.
And then I pass.
It's our turn, boys.
Okay.
Keep your up. I'm gonna go Prismatic Vista. I'm gonna pay another life, crack it, search for a basic land that'll come into play untapped.
Thanks for that ashy up earlier. Yeah. Appreciate it.
Yeah, I'm here to help. I'm gonna tap 4 for City C.
Hey, welcome back.
We're gonna trigger City C. We're gonna mill Nyx Weaver, Buried Alive, and Crypto Sprite. That's gonna net me a special zombie.
I like those tokens. They're very nice.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Cool. That's all I'm gonna do this turn, y'all.
I'm ready to go to combat.
Oh, wait for him too. Got a lot of land over there.
Thank you. I'm gonna do some stuff with it. I'm gonna swing with 4 saplings.
Just 4? And then you got.
I got 3 total.
So 3 is a 7?
7 total damage.
Nice.
Getting me there.
Chunk. Whittling them down, gentlemen.
Mm-hmm. What else you got? Got a lot of mana over there.
Shut the fuck up. Alright? What I want to do, you're not going to let me do. So go fuck yourself.
If you feel that way, go ahead.
You're not.
Wait it out.
Huh?
Do it.
No! I'm going to get fucked.
Just do it. Cowards die alone. Okay. That's it?
No, shut the fuck up. I'm not done with you. I swear to God. Aura shards. Come on, play your shit. Play it. Play it. I know what you're gonna do. I fucking hate you. You're a goddamn cocky son of a bitch and I hate you. But in response, I'm tapping two. I'm making two Zapperlings and I'm destroying your enchantments.
Both of them.
Tell you didn't have it.
In response, a flash out Sunbird's Evocation.
What does that do?
It says, whenever I cast a spell from my hand, reveal the top X cards in my library where X is that spell's converted mana cost. I may cast a card revealed this way with converted mana cost X or less without paying its mana cost.
Ooh,
so I see what you can kill both of these, no problem. Thank you.
Everything has flash, right?
No, yeah, just for that moment.
They just had that?
Yep.
Yep.
But,
I think that works out.
Can't help but notice that you're a little low on mana here.
Yep.
You shut your whore mouth.
You guys got anything else?
Nah, that's it for me.
Go, Alonzo.
Whatever, what did I get rid of instead?
Well, you got rid of my scry and my flash, so there's that. I think what I said in the video was, if it sucks at sorcery speed, it sucks even more at instant. Tooth, claw, and tail. When you set this scheme in motion, destroy up to 3 target non-land permanents.
Jesus Christ.
Aura shards, Gave, and... Oh, you know what? Fecundity as well. I don't want y'all drawing cards.
So you're still gonna draw. Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Draw. Nice. Land.
Nice.
Not looking good.
One, two, three, four, five. I cast Dark Intimations from my hand. And Sunbird's Evocation goes on the stack. I look at the top 5 cards of my library and pick a card with converted mana cost 5 or less to cast for free.
Sounds fine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Welsh Dragon God. And did those go to the battle? Bottom of the graveyard. Alright, so. Each opponent sacrifices a creature or planeswalker and then discards a card. I can return the creature or planeswalker from my graveyard to my hand, then draw a card.
So. I'll tap the Swift Wing.
Okay.
So we're gonna either sacrifice a creature or discard a card?
No, and discard a card.
Oh, and we discard?
And a discard card. Okay.
And I'll discard the Sepalpa. Oh no.
I
don't want that in there.
I will discard Thassa's Oracle, and I will sacrifice the zombie.
Sack a Sapling. And I will discard Woodland Champion.
You're an evil wizard dragon, Harry.
Yep, and then I don't have anything in my graveyard, so I get to draw a card. Oh, that's nice. Well, let me start like this. This is a 4 loyalty planeswalker here. It has all the loyalty abilities of all of the planeswalkers on the battlefield, so if you guys had any... Oh, look. I could have put a +1/+1 counter on anything if I really wanted to.
But you don't have the static, though.
No, I don't have the static, no.
Okay. So he can't tap the mana.
So, I'm going to +1 this to 5, I'm going to draw a card, and then each opponent exiles a card from his or her hand or a permanent they control. Jeez. So, you don't have anything in your hand, you got to exile a permanent.
I'll do the Tortured Existence, exile.
I will discard, or exile, Whisper, Blood, Liturgist. Big exile pile this game.
Then I'm going to tap a Halimar's Depths in a Swamp. For Waste Not, I'm gonna look at the top 2 of my library. Can't cast either of those. They are Dark Deal and Dual Caster Mage. Ouch. So whenever an opponent discards a creature card, put a 2/2 black zombie creature token on the battlefield. Whenever an opponent discards a land card, you get to add 2 black. And whenever an opponent discards a non-creature, non-land card, you get to draw a card. You guys are up.
Untap.
Upkeep.
You're off.
Oh, we got another land.
Oh my god. But can I utilize it? No. Not yet. Play Second Hollow comes into play tapped. Because I do not have another basic.
So I can either pump up my Dryad Sophisticate with Runus's ability and make it a 4/4 and swing at the Planeswalker. I'm not touched. Or I can cast my commander, and it'll just have everything Zatapa has and first strike.
What is this setup?
I think you should cast your commander, because I think that puts a lot of pressure on all those planeswalkers.
For sure.
I'm going to tap 2, and I'm going to cast Life from the Loam, and I'm gonna get up to 3 land cards from my graveyard into my hand.
I'm also thinking, nah, this will come in tap because I can still afford it.
So I'll get Prismatic Vista and Burning Catacombs.
Tap out. Cathro is on the board. Then triggers when it enters. It'll have flying, double strike, vigilance, trample, indestructible, and first strike. So it'll have...
And haste, right?
No haste.
Okay.
Yeah, so it'll have 6 total, so it'll get 6 counters on it. And then it'll have those keywords.
Dope.
Do those get exiled or
playing good
fortune? No, they just unicorn? Stay in the graveyard.
I am so playing up the good fortune unicorn. I'm gonna let Nick finish out what he's trying to do.
Tap 2 for the altar of dementia.
Nice.
I'm ready for combat, how about y'all?
Yep. I'll swing my 2.
Hang on.
You got some before combat?
We might have something really good before combat, but I'm trying to make sure that I can actually do it.
He's got 1 mana.
I know what he's got. Okay, so I'm gonna tap out for Gave.
Cost 7?
Yep. And I'm gonna lower him 2 with tap and tap to make 2 more sapperlings. And then go to combat. Go ahead, swing.
Yep, just 2 at the planeswalker, unblockable.
3 at the planeswalker, totally blockable, but I'm gonna get a trigger. 1, 2, 3 creatures.
Did anything die before we went to combat?
No.
Okay.
Hey, what are you gonna do, Alonzo?
Moving on you.
I'm not attacking.
That's it then.
Well, I can't do 2. I can't do
it. I'm gonna swing the Cruel Celebrant. What do we have on the?
We got a 4/4 flying.
And that's doing just 2 damage to it.
Yeah, I'm blocked.
That's 5. You have what going at it? 3.
Just a 3.
Then I'm gonna swing Cruel Celebrant at it just to make sure. It's a 1/2.
I'm blocking Sidisi. And then you have 1 and
2.
2, so 3.
Die.
No, so here's the thing. Before Sidisi dies, I'm gonna sack all 4 of them to give that -4 and kill your creature. Because of him, I can sacrifice it and give you -1/-1 for each sapperling.
Oh, nice.
So Sidisi's gonna go through and you're gonna...
No, it was still declared as a blocker. Yeah, so
you should have done that before.
But it's fine. It's fine, it's fine.
That you guys
so he's definitely looking at me now because I got a 9/9 with double strike and I have a 5/5 that I can attack now.
Oh.
With death touch and indestructible.
This might not be your game, sir.
I mean, it might not, but we'll see, right?
We will.
All right, next scheme. Let's see what happens. When will you learn? It has Bolas the Boy. When you set this scheme in motion, each opponent exiles the top card of his or her library, and then I can cast any number of non-land cards exiled this way without paying their mana cost. So all y'all flip your top cards for me.
Not nice. Watch it.
Parallel Lives. If an effect would create 2 more tokens. Token creator.
Last 2 turns I do land, and I draw that and get it now.
I can search my library for an artifact or enchantment card, reveal that card, and put it into my hand. Show my library and put it on top. Bolas the Citadel.
Not good. But you don't have Ember's Life.
Yeah, that's true. Go ahead. Go nuts. See what happens.
Do it, dude. I can also make, I can make this an 11. Mm-hmm. +2. I have nothing else to do with my mana anyways.
This is the only turn I have to something, so. It's now or never, man.
Cathrall is definitely...
I wish I had gotten the fucking or done the sapling thing earlier.
Alright, so that goes on top.
I should have just swung with the saplings.
Start the turn, draw that for turn. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm gonna plus this by 1 to 3. I get to draw a card, you guys all exile a card from your hand or a permanent from your side of the control or side of the battlefield.
I will.
I'll have exile.
Exile.
I'll do the token.
I'll go on that.
Flying, tap, vigilance, trample, indestructible, first strike.
Double strike would be awesome.
It has double strike too.
It has double strike?
Yeah. Flying, double strike, vigilance, trample, and I just put first strike on there because it gets a counter for that.
Well,
so even though it's redundant.
Bolas of Citadel for 6. Sunbird's Invocation ability goes on the stack. Look at the top 6 cards in my library. I will cast Frantic Search from the top of my library. It says, draw two cards, discard two cards, untap up to three lands. So I gotta discard two cards now.
May not seem like a lot, but four damage.
I'm gonna discard Nicol Bolas the Deceiver. And
Jesus.
The Elder Spell. And then I'm gonna untap my three blacks.
9/9.
Massacre Girl. When it enters the battlefield, each other creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn. Whenever a creature dies this turn, each creature other than Massacre Girl gets -1/-1 until end of turn. And then Kira dies as well.
My Kira, come back to me. You got anything else?
Tap one for Elixir of Immortality, which is going to make it look the top one, and that's not a one mana card. Neat.
How are you doing?
I'm going to pay three life to play Deliver Unto Evil.
Thank you.
Choose up the four target cards in my graveyard. If I control a Bolas Planeswalker, which I do, I get to return those cards to my hand, otherwise an opponent chooses two of them. Leave the chosen cards in your graveyard and put the rest into your hand. So. I'm gonna grab Frantic Search.
Is any cards?
Yep. Pongify. I'm gonna go with Drown and Unlock as well. And I went on Owen of the Sea. All four of those are gonna get put into my hand. These are gonna go. Sorry, Deliver Unto Evil is gonna get exiled from my graveyard. And then all that said and done, I pass.
Untap. Oh, we got a thing. Yay. I'm gonna play the thing, and then I'm gonna pay one life, and I'm gonna go searching for a basic uncommon land untapped.
That's how we're gonna do this. Song of Creation at Dawn. Search your library for three creatures, reveal them, shuffle your library, and put those on top in any order.
Wanna cut me?
Sure.
Thanks, bro.
Appreciate it.
Let's do what we can for the good of the clan. Welcome, gentlemen. Fate Spinner.
What does it do?
At the beginning of each opponent's upkeep, that player chooses draw step, main phase, or combat phase. The player skips each instance of the chosen step or phase this turn.
So I'm going to reveal a Bog Witch, Doom Whisperer, and a Cairn Wanderer.
Cool.
I can use a Doom Whisperer right now.
Yep. Me too.
So there you go, buddy.
Put these three on top.
We just got to do 6 damage, guys.
That's it.
That's it.
Dropping 9.
That's all I got for two.
Pulling out Gare. That's it.
Alright, Alonzo.
Tap 2 on my end step to gain 5 life. Shuffle this in my graveyard back into my library. There we go. Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain.
I can't hear you.
No, I'm not.
You're right, make sure it's not fucked up. No, not, but fire. When you set this game in motion, it deals damage to each opponent equal to the number of cards in that player's hand.
I have.
Joke's on you.
Ouch.
Well, that kind of works against what I'm doing here.
Wait, what did you pick for Fate Spinner?
Now it's my upkeep. Now I get to choose. I'm going to look at the top card of my library first. I'm gonna use combat. I'm going to choose combat.
So no combat
for combat for me this turn.
All right, go.
Which is just a 4/4, so I'm not too butthurt about it. And then I'm going to draw for turn. I'm going to start with tapping 3. No, wait. Let's do this first. No, let's just do it. Tap 3. Frantic Search. Drop 2 cards, discard up to 2 cards, and then draw 3. Oh, sorry. Untap up to 3 lands. How about the Drawn from Dreams and a Swamp? And then I'm going to untap 3 lands. Four life, Leyline Anticipation.
Mm-hmm. Four back.
Two, three, four. Wait, wait. I already took my hands off it, so fuck it. I am going to Diabolic Tutor right now. But first, Sunbird's Invocation Trigger doesn't stack. I'm gonna go with Court of Ambition. You got 2 mana open?
Mm-hmm. I got 3 mana.
You got shit going on over there. Alright. Color, please. Thank you, sir. Did I play land for turn this turn?
Mm-hmm. No, you haven't.
Okay. I have not. No, I have not. So I'm gonna pay 1 life for Preordain. I'm gonna scry 2 and then draw a card. Draw a card, and then I'm going to pay 1 life for the Jataxian Probe to look at your hand. Draw a card. Oh, that's pretty neat. Play Reliquary Tower for turn, so that way I don't run out of cards or I don't have to discard cards. I'm going to tap a blue to Pongify your commander. I'm going to send a 3/3 monkey over to beat it up.
Well, I'm gonna tap 2, make them lower, and create 2
sublands. There you go, sir. Mucho apreciado. Mm-hmm.
That's numero tres.
It's a hard knock life for us. And I haven't cast anything else from my hand, so. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. This goes up to 4. I get to draw a card, all you don't exile a card from your hand, or a permanent on your side of the battlefield. Then you gotta start exiling lands. Oh, you can exile that monkey I just gave you if you want, or one of the spores.
I'll do...
exile.
My pathway.
Land.
Mm. Alright.
Tempting. But I pass.
This is our chance, fella. This is my moment.
Draw!
It's for everything other way. Just getting that out of the world.
Oh, excuse me, worried.
That's all I can do for there.
That costs, what, 7 now?
Yeah. And I have to put Doomwhisper on top because I have 5 lands. So I get to pay with my life, but I have to.
I'm going to tap out and recast City C. ETB. I'm going to get Fauna Shaman. Undead Alchemist and Mesmeric Orb.
That's gonna create. On my end step, sorry, because of Court of Ambition, I get to draw a card on my end step. Or do you want me to just skip that? Because I fucked up.
Nothing else changed, just take it.
Okay.
They might have given him something to fuck us with.
And then I'm gonna play Verdant Catacombs and pay 1 life, cracking it.
I'm gonna pay 3 and place Kaya.
Hey.
Guy what's Center. It do? Right now it's gonna do creatures you control gain death touch until end of turn, put a 1/1 counter on up to 1 target creature you control.
Cool.
So. Nick, what you got to swing with right now?
The Fate Spinner, a 1/2.
A 1/2, a mm-hmm. whole 1/2.
Right, which he can block, but he can only block one
looks
thing.
Like that ape's the best. Get the pump.
Well, I mean, you got the ape and you got the 2 saps, and I got a 1/2.
Yeah, but as soon as I kill that, all of our creatures are dead.
No, it was only when it ETBs.
So not when it dies. So he can only block one thing, and he will take 3 things worth of damage. So he's most likely going to block your 3-3 because it's the most damage he can take. He's only at 5, so we can knock him down to 2, making Bolas' Citadel useless.
Okay, so I'm going to put him up 1, obviously, to put a 1-1 counter on the, up to 1 target creature you control. I'm going to make it the sapling because you're going to block the ape anyway, so I'd rather damage go through. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to swing with a 3-3, a 1-1, and a 2-2.
I'm going to go to combat with face spinner.
All in my face.
All in your face.
All in my face. All right. So, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to tap a blue and a black to drown in the lock your 3-3 ape. It just destroys it. And then that will trigger Sunbird's Invocation for the top 2. Croxa, Titan of Death's Hunger, enters the battlefield. And when it enters the battlefield, they have to sacrifice unless it escaped. But when it enters the battlefield or attacks, each opponent discards a card. And then each opponent who didn't discard a non-land card this way loses 3 life.
Who didn't discard a non-land?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have to discard a non-land.
You have to discard a non-land or else you take 3.
Alright, I will discard World Shaper.
I'll take 3.
How did you get him summoned?
Well, you still have to discard a card.
Oh, I still do?
Yeah. Okay.
No, you're good. If you discard him, you don't lose 3.
Okay. Yeah.
No, you had it. You took 1 2 more.
No, he did. He was
16.
He was 16. And then...
Question, how did you get him on the board again?
It ETB'd from the top of my library because of Sunburn's Invocation, but it's going to die as soon as it enters the battlefield. So it just comes in, does 3 damage around the board, but your monkey still dies.
Okay, this is before blockers are declared.
Yep. But the neat thing is, I'm gonna kill the 2-2, and then the 2-1-1s are gonna go through. But one of you guys is gonna have to fight over the Court of Ambition.
What do you mean?
Because it gives people monarchy. So if I just got hit.
Oh, I see. You can have the monarch. Because we both did combat damage to him, so that would mean the monarch would go.
You should have the monarch. Well, I mean, yeah, you should have the monarch. I have nothing I can block with. You can get it from me next turn if he wants it.
Okay, fine.
You're the goat.
So I will be the monarch.
So you're going to take
2 damage.
2 damage.
Cool.
Almost there.
I'm going to sacrifice the face spinner to mill me 1. I was hoping to get an untapped zombie out of that.
On your end step, you get to draw a card. That's your turn though, right?
That is...
Yep.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. So this scheme is going to be passed along. And then, a reckoning approaches. When you set this scheme in motion, look at the top 6 cards of your library. I can put a creature card from among them onto the battlefield, put the rest in the bottom of my library in any order. That's nice.
That's the last thing you need.
5, 6. Well, look at that, I whiffed. I got artifact, instant land, artifact, land.
Oh my god.
It bleeds.
Well, that's pretty neat, bruh. Alright, so I'm gonna draw for turn, right? I don't have to worry about that. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna tap a blue and 2. Cast Ghostly Flicker. I'm going to target the Massacre Girl, and actually no, not the Massacre Girl. I'm gonna pick my Darksteel Citadel and Island, and then I'm going to tap a black and 2 red for dual caster mage. So I'm gonna make infinite mana right now, period.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
All my shit, all my lands are going to untap and retap and, until I feel happy about it. So I'm going to say infinite at everything, including colorless, because fuck y'all. And then I'm going to start in the middle of all of that, casting Nicol Bolas, the Ravager, and then switching the Ghostly Flicker target to Nicol Bolas and dual caster mage. Because I have Leyline Anticipation, I can cast shit in between that. I forgot to do the 2 triggers off of the Sunbird's Invocation, so that's 1, 2, 3. I'll take the Soul Ring, I guess. And then, actually, you know what? Let's switch that. How about Feed the Swarm?
So we're discarding our hands, is what you're saying?
No, Soul Ring. Then these two go on the bottom of the battlefield. And then next three. One, two, three. Thought Erasure. I was gonna snipe your hand anyway. So
are we discarding our hands?
Let me see that real quick. You're gonna discard Crater Hoof Behemoth. I'm gonna create two black zombies because of parallel lives. And then after that, I'm gonna surveil one. Let's just put that in the graveyard, because screw it. And then after that, you guys are gonna start discarding your hand, so that's you. So it's four. Do you have anything in your hand?
Nope.
What's that?
Oh, I did. My bad.
Is that a creature? It's an artifact, so I get the draw card off of that. Neat. Cast Narset.
Still haven't technically won.
Now I just need to find a way to put all that mana to use. And I haven't played a land for turn either, which doesn't really matter. I have infinite mana. But when that comes on the battlefield, I'm going to look at the top four cards of my library, and I can reveal a non-creature, non-land card and put it into my hand. Alright, so I'm going to put Commit to Memory into my hand, where I'm going to put a non-land permanent onto the top of its owner's library, second from the top, which is going to send it to the graveyard. I'm going to pick... Let's put Kaya. Fuck it.
Where's it going?
Second to the top of your library. Is it your graveyard again? Oh yeah, you got a Crater Hoof in there.
Yeah.
Give me that.
I recommend Doom Whisper instead.
Nice. Right?
Yeah.
So, I'm going to cast Beacon of Unrest from my hand. And it says, put target artifact or creature card from my graveyard onto the battlefield, then shuffle this back into my library. But I'm going to put Crater Hoof Behemoth on and give the 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, plus 8, plus 8.
For basically just this and Crater Hoof.
No, they all have haste, right?
No, just Crater Hoof.
Crater Hoof? All right.
That's enough to take out. I think at least him, right?
How many you got with 8-8s?
He's got this and this are plus 8, plus 8. They can attack us this turn.
Mm-hmm. At least kill me or him.
So that's 13.
Probably me and you, because I can't block anything. And you can't block anything.
He's got a total
anything.
Of 25 damage, so it's only enough to kill.
Total 25.
Me and you.
Yeah, it's only enough to kill. No. Yeah.
Who's kill the only ones that can swing right now?
Yeah.
This one, these two are the only ones that can swing? Because Bolas just came in this turn?
No, he couldn't kill us both, because he's only got two creatures to swing with.
Yep. I'm just gonna
so if he swung both at you, he'd kill you. If he swung one at me,
the top two. Liliana's Caress gets cast off the top.
Or you.
Then I'm gonna scry two, then draw a card, get those both on the bottom.
What a pickle.
And I'm definitely the bigger threat before.
Yeah, of course, right? Then I'm going to cast Memory from my graveyard, which means every player is going to shuffle his or her hand and graveyard into his library and then draw seven cards.
Okay.
Wait, you had Narset in play already, right?
Yep.
So we...
Oh, you guys can't even draw. I'm sorry.
Lol.
Yeah, my bad.
So we just draw one card instead of seven?
Yeah, just one. Pay one life for Opt. I'm going to scry one and draw a card. Neat.
Misplay.
Draw a card. Nicobolas got activated, so I'm going to draw a card. Everybody exiles a card from their hand or a permanent they control.
So they go their one card that we drew.
Yeah, exactly.
You love
there
it.
There we go.
Exile.
Cemetery Illuminator is going to enter the battlefield. I'm going to look at the top three. I'm going to Frantic Search off the top of my library. I know, right? Just overkill. Draw two cards. Discard two cards.
So,
I'm trying.
You're not.
Draw two cards, discard two cards, okay, then what else would I do? Okay, Cemetery Illuminator, look at the top card of your library anytime, and I'm going to choose Instance. I'm going to exile an instant. And then once per turn, I can cast a spell from the top of my library without life. Shit. Is there anything else I can fucking do?
Sweet.
Okay, he doesn't have
a
combat phase.
Bounty Lord of Luxury, actually I do have a combat phase. Top four.
You do not have a combat phase.
Oh, that card's gone.
That card's gone, yeah.
But you still lose the effect.
Diabolic Tutor, it was already gone before my turn started.
Each upkeep, you refresh it. So he gets to choose each upkeep and it was gone before his upkeep happened. Had I had known this was going to be the deal, I wouldn't have even sacked it.
How can I fucking end this right now, please?
It's not like pass. It's not. You just pass. Just pass your fucking turn. Dude, we have nothing. Literally. I one card. That. You have monsters.
So that's how I end the game.
What?
So Great Merchant Acidil, I just searched it up. And then I'm gonna cast it from my hand. Sunburn Supplication is gonna go off. Look at the top five.
What does it do that wins?
He's gonna neg
points. I'm gonna kill you guys with life points being drained from you. So Thassa Deep Dwelling is gonna get cast from the top of my library just in case this shit for some reason doesn't fucking go through.
Hex is your devotion to black.
Yeah, so this enters the battlefield, then this enters the battlefield. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 life that you guys are gonna lose each.
I have 3 life.
Yep, and then you're gonna get hit with
Crater Hoof.
0 life.
Yeah, Massacre Girl at least, because Crater Hoof's gonna die as soon as you get drained out. So that's how I did it. Finally found out. Thank you. Being patient. Appreciate it.
GG.
Jeez.
Rude.
Good game.
Yeah.
Long game.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. It was just the last turn.
This was a lot of watching you play.
I know.
This was Alonzo's show.
This is why Bolas is evil.
This was Garnet. This was go fuck yourself on the first 2 turns. You can't search things for 3 turns, and I'm gonna have 4 mana on my turn 1.
Yep. That's how it works. Did I steal anybody else's shit? That's always what I have to ask whenever I play any deck.
No. Gave my creator group back.
Okay. I mean, they look like magic cards. We're all good here.
Yep.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah,
that was good.
Thanks everybody for joining us. Appreciate you guys getting spanked for me.
Make sure to like, comment, share, sub, and stay foil.
Salt and say San Diego.
Salt, 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 salt. Salt, 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 salt.